now that we've got some text out there, we want to change the font or the color of the text or maybe the style. To do that, I'm going to double click on it to put us into text edit mode. But we don't see any formatting toolbar like we had before. And we also notice that the whole screen kind of jumps up a little bit when I go into text edit. When I go out of it, it's filled back in by our line and fill bar. We need to turn on our text formatting bar. To do that, we go into View, Toolbars, Text Formatting. We see that it's off here to the right. When I click to go into text edit, now we see that it's over here to the left. Clicking off, we see it disappears. And now the screen doesn't jump around either. So from here, I can select my text and make any change I like. Maybe I'll make this Arial black. And I can change it to bold, italic, underline, and shadow. Let's take a look at shadow. I'm going to have a clouds with a shadow and one without, so we can see the difference. I'm going to turn on the shadow. And we can't see too much of a difference. Let me see if we can't magnify that a little. Well, we can kind of see a difference, but not really. Let's change that color. Let's change our font color, and that's over here on the right. If we make this white, now we can see it a little better. And if I magnify it, there we see that our shadow stands out a little more. And the shadow effect for text is available in LibreOffice Writer. You just need to add it to your toolbar. The rest of this formatting toolbar should be pretty self-explanatory. You've got a line left, center, right, justified, increase spacing. That's for your spacing between lines, like we have clouds and clouds here. If we select that, let's increase the spacing. You can see it getting wider, decrease. And then we've got line spacing, one line space, 1.5, double line spacing, bullets. We can put some bullets in. And here I will just select my bullets and click on the bullet icon. And they look kind of odd because they're centered. So I want my bullets to be left justified, although my text on top of that is centered. And increase the font does just what you'd think it would do. Just a quicker way, instead of going over to changing our font size. And the character and paragraph, that's to brings up our character dialog box to change that, as well as the paragraph. Paragraph you would use if you want to change the spacing. Maybe we want this whole thing some more space from the side. We'd do that in the paragraph. Spacing above, below, we want before the text, so from the left. And here it gives us a little idea of what it's going to look like. And now we can see that it has shifted over a little bit to the right. And from here, we can also use our ruler. Does the same thing. The last thing I want to mention is when we right-click on a shape, we have this text dot, dot, dot to bring up a dialog box. When we see that dot, 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 it usually means there's going to be a dialog box. In this tab, we have alignment. Let's say we want to change our alignment to the upper left-hand corner. Clicking OK, we see that our clouds are now in the upper left-hand corner. Now I'm going to double-click and only select the lower clouds, right-clicking, and we see that our selection's already gone, so selecting and then right-clicking won't do any good. I'll right-click, going back into our text, put this back to the center, and now I'll add the effect of blink. And we've got some more options here to play with the blinking, or I can have it scroll, but I'm going to leave it on blink just to do the effect. And we see it applies to all the text in that shape. If I right click again, we have another thing down here. It says edit style. If I change that, let's change it to something very noticeable. Maybe something like Rockwell Extra Bold. Now when we click OK, we think we're only going to change that one shape. But in reality, we didn't even change that shape. We changed all the others because we changed the style. I'll need to get out of the text edit mode and open up my style. And there we see that we changed the entire style, but it did not change the clouds because we changed that one separately. So that overrode the style, but it did change all the other shapes text. Let's put this back. Put it back to Arial, regular, and we have our text back. So when we right click on a shape, edit style changes the entire style, not just for that shape. The text dot dot dot, that will change just for that shape. But you're limited with what you can change there.